Friends, on this Friday, as we close the week of talking about the things in our lives that we are grateful for as part of this gratitude and generosity series, I wanted to share with you one of my favorite passages, one of my favorite stories of Scripture, where Moses out in the wilderness hears God's call on his life. This comes from chapter 4, Exodus chapter 4, verses 1 through 5. Then Moses replied, "But what if they don't believe me?" They being the Hebrew people, the Israelites. "What if they don't believe me or pay attention to me? They might say to me, 'The Lord didn't appear to you.'" The Lord said to them, "What's in your hand?" Moses replied, "A shepherd's rod." The Lord said, "Throw it down on the ground." So Moses threw it down on the ground, and it turned into a snake. Moses jumped back from it. Then the Lord said to Moses, "Now reach out and grab the snake by the tail." So Moses reached out and grabbed it, and it turned back into a rod in his hands. "Do this so that they may believe that the Lord, the God of their ancestors, Jacob's God, Isaac's God, Abraham's God, has in fact appeared to you." Love that question. What's in your hand? Now, God obviously knew what was in Moses' hand, a shepherd's rod. It was nothing special. We look at shepherd's rod and we think they're nice and unique and creative and kind of cool things, especially in church. But a shepherd's rod was the most uncool thing. It was a tool of a trade. It would have been like looking at someone and saying, "What's in your hand?" And they say, "A screwdriver." We don't put value on that, at least not immense value. And Moses didn't put a whole lot of value on the shepherd's rod. But God says, "What's in your hand?" And he says, "A shepherd's rod." He says, "Now I want you to do what I tell you to do. I want you to take a leap of faith. I want you to trust me. This is going to be weird, but I want you to do what I ask you to do, because you need to see that I will show through you who I am. You want to prove to everybody that you saw God, that you talked to God, that God sent you on this impossible mission? Let me show them through you who I am." What's in your hand? For me, a few years ago, it was my phone. My iPhone. It's bigger now. It's gotten bigger with upgrades. It's more technological now. It can do more. They actually say that there's more power in an iPhone than there was in the Apollo 11 shuttle. Isn't that amazing? But the camera on this allowed me to start making videos for church. They were just simple videos. I didn't really know what I was going to do with them. I would upload them to YouTube or go directly to YouTube Live or Facebook Live, whatever it was. And usually what I would do before I had a tripod, I would just lean it against something. Then one day I got daring and I mounted it in my car and began to give messages as I drove, keeping my eyes on the road, of course. But was able to turn a phone into a tool for ministry. What's in your hand? Is it a phone? Is it a book? Maybe you could teach someone to read. If it's a phone, could you call someone and let them know they're loved? Is it a camera? Could you take pictures of things of beauty and share them with the world that needs to be reminded that there is beauty in the world? Maybe it's a screwdriver. What ramp does someone need to be able to get in their home safely? Home needs repairs, but the pockets are too shallow to be able to afford a contractor. Maybe it's music. A It's a piece of sheet music. Who needs to hear the message of God's amazing grace through the music and song? It's right in your hand. It's a steering wheel. Seems so ordinary, doesn't it? But who needs a ride to the grocery store, groceries delivered? Can you do that? What's in your hand? You see, God can take the things that we don't think much about, that we take for granted, and allow us to do amazing things with them. What's in your hand? And be thankful for it.